So this is an excerpt from Hot Girl, Dream Jordan's book. And it is a dialogue between Nalisha and Kate. Kate is the main character. And in this excerpt, you get to know a little bit about their relationship and how it unfolds in the book. Nalisha pulled me into her closet and flung her mirrored doors open. I looked on in amazement at the rows and rows of clothes and shoes, cramming her rod and shelves like a department store. I have never seen so many clothes in my entire life. Girl, don't play. Man, your parents go all out for you, I said, shaking my head in awe. Parents? Nalisha jerked her head back. Please, girl, my parents don't hit me off like this. I got money from dudes, and I take myself shopping. Say word? Word, replied Nalisha, clapping her hands to emphasize her point. When it comes to me getting mine, I got mad game, okay? Nalisha crossed the room to lift her Gucci tote off the floor. Do you think my bustable parents would pay over $1,000 for this bag? I shrugged. Or this? Nalisha grabbed a thick gold link lying on the edge of her dresser. Maxwell paid mad money for this chain. Believe that. I creased my eyebrows in confusion. So, Mom and Pop don't be grilling you about where you get yours? Please, they don't sweat me, said Nalisha with a dismissive wave. As long as I don't ask them to buy me nothing, they couldn't care less what I do. Lucky you. Yeah, I know, said Nalisha. And I hit the jackpot right before summer vacation. Met this dude named Chase, who was dealing out a Brevoort. As soon as I gave homeboy some booty, he started lacing me up like crazy. And I'd still be getting money if he hadn't gotten locked up. Nalisha shook her head and added, ever since I got a taste for that cream, I can't ever go back to being thirsty. It's so messed up, Chase got himself locked up. True, that's messed up, I said. But my head was thinking, whoa, that's messed up to be sleeping with dudes for money. But nowadays, I try hard to keep my opinions to myself. I get tired of being called old lady whenever I say something moral, like to chicks my age, so I just shut up. Let Nalisha do her thing. Girl, I'm ready to get fierce, said Nalisha. She sashayed back to her closet and started searching for an outfit. She pulled out a red stretch halter top and asked me what I thought. I said it was fire. Then she pulled out a super short black guest skirt. I nodded, tight. Then she unearthed a pair of high-heeled black sandals. Hot. Man, you got it all, I said, fighting back the jealous jitters. Please. You got the same goodies I got, said Nalisha. Ain't no reason why you can't be dressing like that. Nalisha's eyes dropped down to my sneakers. Tell me. Why your tennis shoes are leaning to one side. Nalisha did a couple of leans and started singing, lean back, lean back. Then she busted out into a fit of laughter. I rolled my eyes. First of all, you're not in Maryland anymore. They're called sneakers, not tennis shoes. Duh. I thought I had dissed Nalisha into silence, but she busted out laughing even harder. Well, your sneakers need to sneak off your feet. Because they straight up busted. You need a man in your life. I flipped up my middle finger. Laugh all you want to, but I'll get mine regardless. Get yours. How? Asked Nalisha, looking me up and down again, wiping the tears of laughter from her eyes. I pointed to my head. I got brains, okay? I don't need no dude to lace me. And when I get out of the system, I'll be complete. The system? Nalisha interrupted. Yeah. I'm in foster care. Oh, said Nalisha, her mouth shaped like an amazed O. So, yeah, when I get out of the system, I'm emancipated. I'll go to college, graduate, get myself a good job. Then I promise you, I'll stay laced with my own money, feel me? Wow, said Nalisha. Wow what? I said, thinking she was impressed with my little speech. I didn't know you were a foster child, said Nalisha. You don't really look like one. Well, what does a foster child look like? I demanded. And by the way, I'm not a foster child. I'm in foster care, okay? In a huff, I plopped down on her bed and folded my arms across my chest. Dang. Sorry, exclaimed Nalisha. Don't bite my head off. Well, no need to be labeling me, I said. I don't like labels. Yeah, I can see that, said Nolita. Lifting the tag inside my no-name shirt. Okay, it's not funny anymore, I snapped. Now, if you're finished clowning on me, I have somewhere to be. I jumped up and grabbed my knapsack and headed out of her bedroom. Kate, wait up, wait up. Nolita called back to me, please. I swiveled around and barked at her, what? Don't go yet. I have something to give you. Thanks. Oh.
Now go buy the book.
And you can find out what happens.